Welcome to Understand the Math. In this problem, we're going to use matrices to find H and K such that the following linear system of equations has no solution, a unique solution, or infinitely many solutions. Notice that H and K are located right down here. To solve this problem, we're going to take our linear system and we're going to put it in echelon form. The reason that we're going to do that is echelon form is the form that we use whenever we want to find out what type of solution we're going to have. And then we're going to see what the pivots and right-hand side equal. We always want to begin this type of problem by taking our linear system of equations and putting it in an augmented matrix. Let's go ahead and do that. We have 1, 4, 2H, and then on our right-hand side, we have 3 and K. We want to put this in echelon form, so I'm going to circle our pivot, and we're going to have to get this 4 to be a 0. So the row operation that we're going to use is we're going to take row 2, and we're going to replace it with row 2 minus 4 times row 1. This is going to give us the matrix 1, 2, 3. The top row stays the same, and then we're going to pick up a 0. We're going to pick up an H minus 4 times 2, which is an 8, and then a K minus 4 times 3, which is a minus 12. And this is the matrix that we're going to have to analyze. Let's first look at when we have no solution. Whenever we have no solution, we're going to have a row of zeros equal to a non-zero number. So what we're going to do is we're going to force our left-hand side, h minus 8, to be equal to 0. And then we're going to force our right-hand side, k minus 12, to not equal to 0. So this gives us h is equal to 8 and k is not equal to 12. I'm going to go ahead and highlight this because that's our solution when we have no solution. Now let's look at what's going to happen when we have a unique solution. When we have a unique solution, every column in our matrix is going to have a pivot. So let's go back up and let's look at our matrix. And I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to circle our columns. Or in other words, I'm going to circle the pivots in our columns. We have to have every column have a pivot. So that means that H minus 8 cannot be equal to 0. And that will make sure that we have a pivot there. So this is going to mean that H is not equal to 8. And let's go ahead and let's highlight that. Let's now look at our last one. This is when we have infinitely many solutions. When we have infinitely many solutions, we're going to have a row of zeros on the left-hand side and 0 on the right-hand side. So on our left-hand side, we're going to have h minus 8 equals 0. And then on our right-hand side, we're going to force k minus 12 to also be equal to 0. So this gives us a solution h is equal to 8 and k is equal to 12. So that's our solution when we have infinitely many solutions.
If this video has been helpful to you, please consider subscribing to my channel. Keep believing in yourself and have a great rest of your day.